preview, so you two can review what we do. 20 years in this business, how you sell soul, she wins. People bear witness. Thank you for letting us be ourselves. So don't mind me if I repeat myself. These simple lines be good for your health. To keep them crime rhymes on the shelf. Live, love life like you just don't care. 5,000 leaders never scared. Bring the noise, it's the moment they feared. Get up, still a beautiful idea. Get up, throw your hands in the air.
Yes, and welcome back, everybody. Thank you for joining in for episode number 2 of the Get Set Show. With me, as always, is the ever so lovely Reza Thompson. Reza, how are you doing today, mate?
Fantastic. Really excited about the Australian Open. The first 2 days was electrifying.
Yeah, we were extremely lucky. We got to go down there for day 1 and 2. We got to be in Melbourne Arena, Rod Laver, and Margaret Court all over the grounds. Reza, what was your standout for the first day 2?
My standout was the 10 Aussies that made it to the second round. Some really great stories, which we'll touch base with a bit later, but awesome for the Aussies to get through.
Yeah, no real major upsets either for the Australian Open. All of the top 10 seeds for both the men's and the women's made it through. So pretty stock standard, no real major upsets in the first couple of days, but we did get to see a pretty exciting match last night.
The Melbourne Arena was on fire, and Nick was amazing. A very mature, strong performance from Nick, and unfortunately, we didn't get to see any of the underarm serves.
No.
But if you want to improve yours, here's how.
Oh, then see you there. Hey, everybody. Reza here from Get Set Tennis Show. And here is a tip for the comeback shot of the year, the underarm serve. Don't call it a comeback.
He said he would. He said he would in the reaction.
Before you get your opportunity, you gotta set it up. A couple of big serves to the body will make them return from behind the baseline, and that's when you've got them. Hook, line, and sinker.
Oh. 40-30.
Goodness me. Look at that. Look at that.
Now that you've got your opponent pooping in their pants, it's time to get sneaky.
I am very, very sneaky, sir.
I see that. All right. I'm ready to hit another big serve. Or am I? Always important to disguise the serve. Pretend you're about to hit another big one. As you're on the front foot, instead of leaning back, you're just gonna stay on the front foot, undercut with a bit of slice, to draw your opponent in.
All right, get back, further, go long, that's it. Seriously, dude.
It's also important to work on your fake apology.
I'm simply here to apologize.
Sorry.
Yeah, you will be sorry. Some call it an unfair shot. Some call it unsportsmanlike. You be the judge. All we know is it's allowed and it works. This is Reza from the Get Set Show. Back to the studio, boys.
There you have it, guys. The perfect way how to hit an underarm serve. Rez, you nailed that one. Well done, mate.
I appreciate that, mate. It takes a lot of effort and a lot of training, as Nick showed in the last couple of years.
Have you ever done an underarm serve in a match?
You know, in a match, no. But with my students, I have, and I'm actually 14-0 against students.
Really?
Yes.
It's a good stat.
Yeah, I keep count of those things.
Try it out there, guys. Rez, you said you want to talk about the Aussies. Let's talk about the Aussies. 10 out of 14 got through the first round, which is a pretty big for us. Who impressed you on the first 2 days?
I'm going to pick two players here. We saw Alexi Popperin play Joe Wilfried Tsonga. Joe Wilfried Tsonga was not at his best, but Popperin is and will be a champion of the future. He's quite an amazing talent. And it was 2 sets to 1. The first set was probably the real test, and he managed to compete at a high level. And he's only 20 years old, same age as Diminar, and he's got some weapons. So I'm hoping and thinking he's going to be a star of the future. Another one, Priscilla Hahn on the female draw. She was in Canberra. She hits a fantastic ball, plays extremely well. She got through the first round straight sets. I'm very excited to see how far she can go in her future as well.
Yeah, definitely some standouts there. The big ones for me were the favourites, or I guess the Aussies on both the men's and the women's side, who we believe have the greatest chance of going all the way through. And we'll start with number one, Ash Barty, and how amazing she was. She lost the first set, came out a little bit shaky. But what I like about Ash was she regathered herself, people say she's kind of had a mixed preparation. She lost first round up in Brisbane. She won Adelaide. Mm. She come over here. She has to play an indoor match. She hasn't had much of a warm-up, a hit. So I think she adjusted quite well to the conditions. And I think we saw just a real true gritty performance from Ash, which is going to give her huge confidence leading into the rest of the tournament. And then probably the favourite on for the Aussies on the men's side in Nick Kyrgios. Nick looked like he played with a completely different sort of aura last night. He was energetic. He got frustrated, but he wasn't getting frustrated like he used to do. He was getting frustrated that he wasn't executing his performance and he knew he could do just that little bit better. And I think everything that's been going on with the Australian bushfires and things like this and the big pull that Nick's really had in making this Aces for Bushfire movement a big thing, it really played on him. And he had some really nice words with John McEnroe at the back end of the interview. So have a quick look at this.
I'm guessing you request to play out here in Melbourne Arena because the energy is unreal out here with these fans. You're bringing it.
Yeah, you go. I mean, this is probably my favorite court in the world. I always request to play here early on, and I just feel super comfortable. You guys are the best. I feel the support. I just move like a giraffe sometimes. I just tripped over. That's really it. It was. I'm pretty dramatic sometimes. You know all about that, though.
All right. Finally, I just want to say this is my one last. This is the push. I just want to say that from this point forward, I want to donate $1,000 to the Bushfire Relief Fund for every set you win the rest of this tournament. I'll say it then. Good luck the rest of the tournament, Nick. I hope you go a long way. Nick Kyrgios, everybody.
Yeah, as you can see there, the legendary Johnny Mack donating $1,000 for every set that Nick wins in this Australian Open. And he's really thriving in this environment, especially with that crowd last night, isn't that right?
The crowd really helped him through that nervous moment because technically this is the first personal match he's played for himself. The last three events being the Rod Laver Cup, Davis Cup, and ATP Cup. So fantastic for him to, you know, feel that nervous energy in a different way. And I think this is really driving him to compete a lot better and a much clearer head. So hopefully, let's not jump to conclusions here and think he's going to win the Australian Open. Let's just enjoy each moment, let him compete the way he likes to compete.
Yeah, couldn't agree more. Well, for those of you who have been watching the Get Set show for a while or been fans of ours, you would realize that Rez and I are both competitive ourselves. So, what we decided to do was head towards Mount Ainslie, Canberra's most famous mountain, and have a race to see who's the fastest up the mountain with a twist. Enjoy. Okay, so here's the deal. When we started talking about the Get Set show, we were already in discussions about having a Reza versus Nelson challenge. Reza and I are constantly in competition with certain things, whether it be athletic ability, whether it be in the smarts departments, you know, technological advancements, vocabulary, you name it. We're always competing. So today we're continuing on the theme with the Mount Ainslie challenge. So for those of you who don't know, Mount Ainslie is a hill in Canberra, or actually it's a mountain, hence Mount Ainslie. Quite steep. Got a beautiful view up the top. If you're fit, it takes you about 15 minutes to run it. It's a really good workout. Now, our challenge today is to race up Mount Ainslie. If you really push yourself, you can get up to the top by the time somebody calls an Uber, they come to pick them up and then drive them up to the top. If I win the coin toss, I think I'm still gonna go the Uber, but it's not a guaranteed win. However, I don't think there's anything better than getting up to the top of the hill and then seeing Rez absolutely gas, whether I win or not. I don't know how Rez feels about this whole thing, but all I can say is it's gonna be a close race. So you ladies just conquered it, well done. All right, my palms just got a little bit sweaty. I'm nervous now. Let's do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're here at Mount Ainslie. You really hate losing, don't you? I've done it in under 14 minutes. Dude, some people have done it even quicker. I did it the first time. I think I stopped about 10 times just going, what am I doing?
Heading over to the starting point now. Rez, how you feeling?
Just preparing myself.
Well, at least it's nice and green.
And
hey,
you're
gonna need one of them in a minute. Carry you up the hill. Mount Ainslie.
You feeling good?
I'm feeling great.
Well, let's go up there and let's rock, paper, scissors this one.
Rez, no dogs allowed. Unlucky, mate.
Kokoda track, Mount Ainslie summit track. 4.5 kilometers return.
Return.
Halve that, Nelson.
That's
2.25
even.
Nervous?
We're going scissors, paper, rock.
didn't give anything away then, did I? Scissors, tape, a rock. No!
Yes. Yes.
First time rock has ever let me down. Ever.
Yes. I've got to stretch now.
What's on the line here? What does winning get?
That's just the pride thing. I think this is a good educational thing too. Like people
want to know.
They want to know.
Is it quicker to walk or is it quicker to...
Well, are you going to walk?
I'm not going to run it. I'm going to win.
All right, we start from the gate.
All right, ready?
Set.
Go.
Oh, this is already hurting. I just got to set a good pace. One foot in front of the other. How hard can it be? It's bad that my arm's sore from holding the camera up.
Uber X, fancy.
Confirm pickup. Oh, we got a Camry.
We're going to go up there really quick. Maybe we should get this bad boy.
I can literally still see the car park. It's not a good sign. Oh, crap.
Arrival in 3 minutes.
Nelson's approach to most things is really aggressive, like go hard. And I just don't think he's going to last. I reckon he's walking right now.
400 meters in. Man, it's just steep, this thing. Dry too. Oh, I wish I did more calf raises in my 20s.
This is a disaster. I feel for the little guy. I really do.
Just keep swimming. Just keep swimming.
I think Nelson is a fit young man. He's a strong young man, but just a bit bullheadish. He goes a little too hard too early.
I went out too hard too early. Come on.
I'm gonna just rest. God, my legs, man. You know what? I was so confident, I didn't even wear my running shoes. He always goes rock.
It's a Parker thing.
Do you think he'll last? Do you think he'll run the whole way?
I think he'll be a medium jog.
He's pretty tough.
His second place ain't all that bad. A lot of people came second in a lot of things. We still remember them. Buzz Aldrin, the Atlanta Falcons, and Super Bowl a couple of years ago. That's all I can remember right now, but.
The mighty Uber driver. Oh, it's a brand new one. All right, we're going the back.
Are you able to do a U-turn? Or? We've got a silly friend, silly chicken leg friend named Nelson. He's running up there right now. If this goes really well, we're going to basically let everyone know how great Uber is, which everyone already knows. So, especially with your 4.9 star rating.
My throat is on fire. Come on. I hope Rez got a miserable Uber driver. I hope he's miserable right now.
Where are you from? We're bonding already. This guy's awesome.
Now, Jack's on him. Matty getting fit. What's he doing? Nothing. That's right, Rez. You got nothing. Nothing on me. King Kong ain't got shit on me. Oh, King Kong needs a break.
He started at that section over there.
About 5 minutes ago.
You want to have it stop all around? Have it
stop. Give me something. Whew. Mate, see that? Gave me the old runner's nod. And the us hardcore runners know what it is. Whew. Just gave me my second win, man. I'm coming.
Arriving at 11:07. Big tip for you, my friend. Big tip for you.
You feeling confident, Rez?
You know what I'm feeling? Comfortable, plush leather seats. I've got a great guy here, Karushi. I just think I've had a better experience than Nelson has.
Oh, any fitter, I'd be frightening.
What kind of experience will he be having right now, looking at nature? Or will he be just so focused on breathing?
I think he's struggling at the moment.
Oh, I reckon he's walking right now.
All right, time to channel my inner Kathy. Joke's on you. Shortcut. Can see the summit. Think of all the times. The underdog one. Average Joe's. Peter LaFleur. Beat Cobra Kai. Then he beat Cobra Kai. Cobra Kai's in Karate Kid. Globo Gym. There's another one though. Karate Kid. Beat Johnny. From Cobra Kai. Stop talking, Nelson.
I don't want to rub it in. Like,
what would Nelson do? Would
Nelson
he rub it in?
Nelson would rub it in like crazy. He's a bit cocky. Nice guy. Just very excited. I compliment the guy. Got a lot of abuse in the kitchen last night.
You get to be hangry.
Yeah.
I think that's a Parker trait. Buster's the same.
I don't know what it is. It's let me down. I had popcorn for breakfast. You know what else isn't helping? These little skinny legs I got. It's not my fault though. Genetics. My dad was a damn bat. This one's for you, Daddy Bat. Let's go, Daddy Bat.
We're almost arrived here, people.
Look at all this smoke.
This will be perfect.
Yes, thank you very much.
You guys have a great day.
You have a great
you
day.
Too.
Big tip coming
I'm
away,
glad
my
you beat him.
Karush is confident, I'm confident, Matt's confident.
Thank you very much, Mr. Uber driver. So we are at the top.
A bit thirsty.
Yeah.
I just feel for the guy.
He gets a 5-star rating.
5-star rating. What a lovely guy.
What do you think he's feeling right now?
I feel like a woman, a pregnant woman in labor. Nah, this is harder than labor. Yep, that's blood.
How should we greet him? The question is it false hope we give him
resounding admiration for the effort?
Or do we rub it in?
Or do we rub it in?
If you had one shot, one opportunity, seize everything in life you've ever wanted, just capture it, let it go. It's my motto. Let's go!
What will he be complaining about the most?
His chicken legs.
Hurry up, Nelson. Like, you've got stuff to do, man. He's not going to be here for a while.
Yeah.
You'll do it. I just want to see his condition. I'm excited to see his condition.
Is it a hard run? Good luck.
Last set, best set. And a boy, mate. How get him? Just passed on the runner's knowledge. He'll make it all the way down here. Oh, damn. Nope.
That guy left the same time we did. I think the guy left, like, just a bit after. Two butterflies.
If there's you who are wondering, that little white building there, that's where I started, so no big deal. It separates the men from the boys, sheep from the wolves. Almost.
First visual I think we'll get is directly in this tree line. All right, I think he's over it.
I think he's pulled a pin.
Yeah. I hear voices. That's not a good sign. I see dead people. Run!
Those legs carrying that upper body.
He doesn't skip arm day.
No! I think I got lost along the way, that's why it took so long.
Could you time it?
You guys must have, like, just got here, right?
We just got here.
No, don't tell me that.
We just got here.
Are you for real?
Like 2 minutes.
No.
Yeah, you should have gone hard, mate.
Idiot.
That's some water.
How was it?
That sucked so hard.
We had aircon.
So did I. It's called the smoke from Creamy. I am dying. Yeah. Went to another level there, Rez. Not gonna lie. Found myself.
Beautiful view up here. You okay?
Yeah,
I'm good.
Did we vomit?
We can't. I spat blood out.
Oh shit.
What?
Yeah.
I think because I brushed my teeth too hard this morning. I don't think it had anything to do with my fitness levels. Like, I think.
Yeah, how are the legs feeling?
Legs let me down. I'm not gonna lie.
Legs let you down? So if you had legs like this, you would be better. Is that what you're saying?
If I have one leg like that, I'd be better.
Well, yeah, we had some interesting commentary from a local too.
Really?
Yeah. Because he said it was
Just beep it. Soft. Well, everybody, thanks for joining us for our first major Get Set Show race. One zip. But hey, Nels, how about double nothing?
Race away now?
Absolutely.
Let's go.
Scissors, paper, rock. Back to the studio.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. The Uber is the quickest. And running up a mountain is not fun.
No, especially when there's a lot of smoke in the area.
Yeah,
we probably picked the worst day to do it.
Yeah, it was bad.
Win.
But you know what? You were close. Mm. 5 minutes, you could have been there. We'll work on it. Anyway, moving on. One of the things that I've always been excited about and really intrigued about was Canada. Canada's bringing up some really top tennis players. Mm. You've got Denis Shapovalov, Felix, I can't pronounce his last name, sorry. And also you've got Andruska, who won the US Open title. Andruska didn't show up. And Chapo bombed out yesterday in four sets as a quality player, and so did Felix as well. So those are some of the top stars from Canada. So a bit of a meltdown on the Canadian side for me.
Yeah, definitely not the start that they wanted. There is still a little bit of hope. Milos Raonic, big serving Canadian. Mm-hmm. He's done well in Grand Slams before, and I feel like if he can stay fit for the 2 weeks of the Open, he can rattle some cages. But these young guys, there's still a lot of pressure, they've still got a lot to learn, and they've got plenty of time. Andreescu's only young, Felix only 18, 19, I guess.
Yeah, 19, I think. It's 20.
It's scary how much time these guys still got. So they'll take this as a bit of a lesson, a learn. You've got to make sure you're fit, you can't take any match for granted, and I have no doubt they're going to come back stronger and better. But what they do have to do, Rez, they've got to make sure that the nutrition is on point.
Mm.
So maybe they should take a leaf out of the Get Set Tennis book and join us for our next episode of Brekkie Bites.
Yummy. Hey everyone, welcome to Brekkie Bites episode 2. Well, last time we did a very quick one.
Sure did, Rez.
We have an omelette dish here, which is one of Nelson's favourite. We call it the Get Set Omelette.
So, as we go through ingredients, a couple of rashers of shortcut bacon, handful of spinach, you'll need an avocado, salt and pepper, try out some feta cheese. Game changer. You also need some sourdough bread because we want to make sure we eat up our carbs as well. Again, it's all about making sure you have a nice balanced diet, hitting your carbs, your healthy fats, and your protein goals. 2 eggs out of the basket. Not the basket.
Crate. Carton.
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 Carton of eggs, mate.
Where's the bin at?
2 full eggs, and then he's also gonna get 1 egg white. Grab another egg, but I want you to separate the yolk from it. So if you could chop up the bacon into some strips for me. So really,
just kidding.
I always pop the toast down when you do your first flip of the omelet. Timing is everything. You want all your ingredients to be hot at the same time. Don't be a jerk, just time it right.
He's so angry.
Idiot, I want my omelet. We're gonna throw him an avocado. So Rez. So while Rez does that, you're gonna do four shakes of salt. One, two, three, four.
So you're a shaker, not a palmer or a pincher.
Nope, not a pincher, not a palmer, not a salt bay. I'm a, what am I?
Shaker.
Then you don't need them anymore. Neither of this.
What oil are you using? Extra virgin olive oil.
Extra virgin olive oil.
Robust flavor. This is Espanol. Espanol olive.
Ah, hola, ¿cómo está?
Bien.
El gusta Nedal no gustaría el taco.
Unbelievable. This is gonna
happen. You want your pan nice and hot. How hot is it?
It takes a bit of time. Should we have maybe heated that before while we're doing
Well, I thought I did, Rez, but sometimes things just don't work out, mate. And that's just the way it is, so deal with it. And moving on.
So grouchy.
And we're going to pour that in, and we want it to spread out. There we go.
Looks like Medvedev's head.
What? Champion.
Perfectly symmetrical.
That's actually really good.
Pro tip, whatever level of heat you usually do on the toaster, perhaps do half of it. Flip the toast and do it again on the same number.
Unnecessary because the toaster has heating pads on either side of the bread.
Correct.
You're an idiot. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get a pinch of feta here and I'm going to put that as my layer base. You can do it without talking, please, Rez. I'm trying to discuss it with the people.
What level do you want?
Just whatever, dude.
Level four?
Yeah, cool. Four. I don't care.
You gotta cook.
Rez, shut up! Okay, so what you do is you put the feta. Fire, now you can't make me talk. So that's our base layer. We go there. Next, we go onto the bacon. So we'll throw our bacon bits on the side. Then we throw a little bit of spinach. Spinach will wilt up. You can cook your spinach first, but I just throw it straight in there. And then we throw on a little bit of avocado.
Pro tip, always hydrate while you're cooking.
Thank you.
That'll cool you down.
And as you see, we've got a pretty good flip here. Omelets need attention. They're like small trees. It's time for the all-important flip. Rez, would you like to do the honors?
Let's give it a go.
No, not allowing you to do it.
Oh.
Because what you got to do is, you've got to get underneath it so you know it's not sticking. Rez would never have done that. He would have gone straight in and messed the whole thing up. Take care of the toast.
Got it. Do you want a plate for the toast?
Yes, Rez, I want a plate for the toast.
You want a big plate?
Yes. Okay, and here we go with the flip. So we're going to get a whole bunch under, big old flip. And look at that. Poetry in motion, kids. If you want to know how to flip eggs, come and see Get Set Tennis. 0422 809 160, available Monday through Saturday.
That's your personal number.
Yes, it is, actually. I'm now going to turn this, what's this called? Electric fry pan. I'm going to turn that off.
So why is it still hot?
Because it doesn't go off automatically, like I wish you would sort of.
Does the heat sort of stay there for a little while?
Yep. Okay, if you don't give a hoot about presentation, just throw your avocado on, like Rez, and even put a pit in there so small children choke. And then we're going to throw our omelets on the plate with it. And there we have it. We have the special Get Set omelet. It's actually less calories than the oats. Give it a little taste test.
I think we need to try this out.
All right.
There's a lot of passion that went into this one. Some can confuse that with anger, but we'll move on. Nelson, it's worth the verbal abuse you give me. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was the Get Set Omelette, and what a dish. What a chef, what a guy. Just don't cook with him. Back to the studio with those two handsome fellas, and we'll look forward to seeing you at our next episode of Brekkie Bites.
Can't wait, see you then.
You're such a dick.
There you have it, team, the ultimate Get Set Omelette, and also how to treat your employees poorly. I am so, so sorry. Looking back at that, I was a jerk that day. I don't know what happened, I feel bad.
But you do suffer from hangryism, which is like a common thing.
Yeah.
I feel your pain. Yeah. But it didn't hurt, man. It's okay. I knew it was from a good place. It's all good.
Okay, well, tell you what, Rez. I've been thinking about this for a while, and I feel so bad about how I treated you in that. I'm going to give you an uninterrupted 60 seconds on the Get Set Show to talk about whatever you want, and your time starts now.
So I've got this episode called, or this part called, What's That Racket? And one of the things I've noticed that on the pro circuit, you see a lot of players experimenting with new frames. So you'll see a player hitting, and for example, Serena Williams, who's a 23 Grand Slam champion, she's looking to win the first Grand Slam as a mother. She's been struggling a little bit, obviously losing some close finals. She's pulled out one of these. And if you notice, this racket here is completely black, okay? And what it means is that it's a custom-made racket specifically for her. Balance, weight, things like that. She's just trying to figure out what it is. So if you're looking at that racket going, what's that racket? She doesn't even know yet. She's just using it, trying it out, seeing how it goes. There's quite a few of these out there. Andre Rublev has one. Federer had one when he was transitioning from his smaller racket to try and up his game. And it does show some positive results. So that's what it is, that racket.
Boom, you did that well. 50 seconds. Good job.
I'm trying to be organized and try and get things in the right order. So
you're getting better. It's good.
Thanks.
I like it. Awesome. Guys, before we start to wrap up the show, we do have our final segment, which is our top five. And today we're going to be talking about our top five One Slam wonders. Now, these are those players who were incredible players. No one wins a Grand Slam without being an incredible player.
Absolutely.
But they couldn't quite crack it more than one time. So please enjoy our top five One Slam wonders, starting with our good friend, Andy Roddick. Andy Roddick, the big serving American from Texas. In 2003, he won his first and only ever Grand Slam. It was a US Open title against Juan Carlos Ferrero. It's hard to put Roddick in this category because he did do so well in other Grand Slams. He probably should have won about another two or three, in my opinion. A Wimbledon final against Fed, he was so close. But number five, Andy Roddick, only with one slam.
Number four, Sam Stosur, the Aussie. She won the 2011 US Open, defeating Serena Williams. Not defeating, destroying Serena Williams. Mm. She did, however, make a French Open final as well, but since then, Grand Slam success has been a little more difficult in the singles realm. Sam Stosur deserves that US Open wholeheartedly, but she is in the category of One Slam Wonder.
And we take the number third spot all the way to Sweden. Thomas Johansson, in 2002, he shocked the world and beat Murat Safin at the Australian Open final and did pretty much bugger all after that. He's one of those players everyone kind of has to Google and be like, really?
He was
a player, but I'm sure he doesn't stress out too much when he looks over at that Australian Open trophy. So he takes the number three spot, Thomas Johansson.
Coming in number two, Marianne Bartoli against another first-time slam finalist, Sabine Lisicki, the 2013 Wimbledon champion. Bartoli made a run all the way and took the title out and then retired.
Good way to go.
Great way to go. Fantastic for her. She is now the 2013 Wimbledon champion forever. So well done, Marianne.
And the number one spot, you are going to go, who the hell is this guy? Gaston Gaudio. In 2004, before Rafael Nadal started his ridiculous run at the French, Gaudio defeated Guillermo Coria from Argentina. He just came out of the blue and absolutely annihilated Coria from the third set onwards. He was down two sets and he came back and won, and once again just went walkabout. No one's ever heard of him. I think I saw him working down at Flinders train station actually the other day.
At the 7-Eleven?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So big things from Gaudio. So that wraps up our number one spot for One Slam Wonders. Well, there you have it, guys. Our top five One Slam Wonders. Rez, I was actually going to put myself on there. Sixth spot I took out. I won a Tatra Open back when I was 15 and never won a singles title since.
That's quite a drought.
Mm. Yeah, I'm still a long time between drinks. Rez, any final thoughts going into the next couple of days of the Australian Open?
I'm just looking forward to some great tennis. I want to wish all the Aussies all the best of luck. There's 10 Aussies out there you should all be cheering for. But there's going to be some great tennis. And don't forget, once you've got the Aussie Open over, you've got your own tennis to worry about. So get on the courts, everyone.
That's right. Guys, thank you so much for joining us for episode 2 of the Get Set Show. This is Rez and Nelson signing out.